What we're going to end up accomplishing today is to get the create button and the edit button to both display a modal once we click it. Right now, the create button shows up and it has all the create messages and methods and stuff that we need in there to create a brand new one. But right now, our edit button doesn't do anything. So if we head into the text editor and go to resources, JS, pages, admins, roles, index, and open that up. And then we head up to the table where we have that button, which it's right here. We want to add a method. So we'll say at click equals edit modal. Okay, and then we want to pass in the role that's coming in from this v4 loop up here. Okay, to make sure that we get the correct one. So now if we go down to our method section, we can just put it, we can copy this one, paste a new one, and this one's now going to be edit modal, and then we also need to pass in the role. So before we get it to show, we'll say alert role ID. Okay, let's take a look at the browser and see what we get. So refresh, we can click edit, and now we're getting ID of 1. Okay, and then this one should be 2. Okay, fantastic. And now we can also uncomment out this modal show, and we can get rid of this alert. So now we need to take all of these form data properties, and we want to pass them through the edit modal so that they can be displayed in the modal. Okay, so what we need to do here now is we'll say this form name equals role name, this form ID equals this role ID. Well, we don't need this. Okay, and this form permissions equals role permissions. So let's go ahead and refresh and see if we're getting that yet. We'll go back, refresh, and then we'll go ahead and click edit. Okay, fantastic. So now we see that everything is being propagated as far as what it's supposed to be. So if we also go down to, let's say, one of the new ones that we did, same thing, we get the role name and the create role. So before we set this up to edit, why don't we go ahead and change up this create new role, and we'll make it more dynamic so that we can also use it for our create. Okay, so let's head back to the text editor. And now we want to create some sort of reference point. So for instance, if you come up to the top here where we have the form, where is it? If we look for title, no, we need the other one. Okay, this one, create new role. We're going to need this to come into two different forms. So what we can do here is we're going to put some curly brackets, and then we'll say form title. Okay, and then we want to go down to our methods, or our default, our exports. Okay, and in here we can create a computed property. So we'll say computed, curly brackets, don't forget the comma. Okay, and now we can say form title. Okay, curly brackets. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to create a reference point. Okay, we're going to say edited index is -1. Okay, and all that's doing is just referencing which index it is. So we just want to reference it as -1, and you'll see why a bit later. Okay, so now if we come down to the form title, okay, we can now do return this edited index equals -1. Then we'll have the title of create new role. And if it's not, we'll have the title of edit current role. So all we're doing is just giving it a way of showing either one or the other. Okay, and that's all that is. So now that when we open the modal, we'll put it in the first modal. In the edit modal. So under this, when we open it, okay, it'll say this.editedIndex equals this role's index of role. Okay, we're just setting the index to something other than -1, and it'll be the index of the roles. Okay, so now down here for the open modal, before we open it, we'll just go ahead and reset it. So it'll be this edited index equals -1. So just in case it's not, we want to make sure it is. Okay, so let's see if we at least got that working. Let's try to open up the create and make sure that we're getting the correct title. So refresh, should say create new role, close it. Now when we edit, should say edit current role. So now we've managed to make the title dynamic, and we can go back and forth and it'll still be the same because we're clearing it. Okay, fantastic. But here's the thing, when we go to click create, all of that information is still propagating and it shouldn't. So the way that we can do that is, we've done it before, when we click open modal, we can just say this form reset. Okay, and that should clear the form for us. So let's try it again and make sure that that's empty now. We'll go back, refresh. Okay, we'll click create. There's nothing there. Close it. Edit. We have our information. Close it. Create. Our role is now empty again the way it's supposed to be. And this still works as it's supposed to. Okay, fantastic. So on to the next thing. The next thing we want to change is the button text, because the way it stands now, this says create, and we want to change it to edit or create. Okay, so let's make this more dynamic as well. So add some curly brackets and we'll say button text. Okay, and we'll do a very similar thing to this computer property. We'll copy it, paste it, and now this we can change to button text. Okay, so it'll be return this.edited index equals -1, and then this will be just create. And now this one will just be edit. So let's go back and make sure that that took. Refresh. Now if we click create, our button says create. And if we click edit, our button now says edit. Okay, fantastic. We can also do the same thing with the form submission. Okay, so let's go up to where it says form. And here we're going to do, let's say check mode. Okay, and then we'll come down to our data properties. And under this edited index, we'll say edit mode is false. We'll set it to false initially. So what this is basically going to do is it's just going to compare if we're in edit mode or if we're in create mode. And that's just how we're going to set this up. Okay, so right now we can go down to our computed properties and can kind of copy paste this. We'll do check mode and then bring this down here. And then we'll say return this edit mode equals false. So what we're saying is, if this edit mode equals false, then the method that we're going to use is this dot create role. Okay, and if it is in edit mode, then the method is going to be this dot, well, we'll call it edit role, which we haven't made yet. Okay, so let's go down. And just to kind of test this out, when we open up the edit modal, okay, we need to call this edit mode equals true. And then when we're just opening the modal for the create, we'll say this edit mode equals false. Now, when we come down here, I'm just going to comment this out just so we can do some testing. So we'll say alert. Create, and then our, was it edit or create? Edit or update? Yeah, this dot edit role. So edit role. And then we'll just alert edit, just so we can see if these are hitting the right methods. Okay, so let's go back to the browser. We'll refresh. And now if we start with create, we'll hit the create button. Create. and we are hitting the create method. Fantastic. So now when we hit the edit button and edit, okay, why don't we try it with console log instead? Or edit role, this edit role. Yeah, it should have worked. Well, let's try and do it with console log and see if that works. If it doesn't work, then we'll try something else. So, console log create. Console log edit. Okay, let's try this one more again. Go back, refresh. Okay, and then we'll try it again. We'll hit create. Need to open up the inspect tools. And go to console. Okay, so we'll click create, and now we're getting create here. We click edit, edit, and now we're getting edit here. I think it worked before, it just didn't, it didn't finish compiling. Hopefully. We'll try it and see how it goes. If not, we'll just change up how we do it, like I said. Okay, so we can turn this back on and turn this off. And now we can also go ahead and create the edit role method. Okay, so for now, even though we haven't created the method, we'll just sort it out here. Okay, so now this will be patch. This will be update. You also need to pass in this form ID, this form, and then everything else we can leave the same for now. So why don't we go ahead and create that route? So web routes. So in here, we're going to use form. We're going to use route model binding. So this is going to be patch. And then in some curly brackets here, we're going to say role. And then this. And that will be update. And then let's go ahead into the controller and work that out. So if we scroll down to update, we can now do if auth user. Well, let's not do that yet. We'll just say role sync permissions collect. Then it's going to be request permissions, and then we're going to pluck the ID to array, and we need a semicolon. Then it's going to be role update name equals request name, and then return back. Okay, so let's give this a go and see if it works. We'll go back. Refresh. We'll just close that for now. Okay, and then we scroll down and we'll try and edit this one. Okay, so why don't we try adding another one? Edit. Another new role. Let's see, refresh. And it went through. Okay, fantastic. So let's try and make sure that that worked again. Let's go ahead and get rid of this one. Edit. Okay, and that needs to refresh, but we'll take care of that a little later. We'll just refresh the page for now and make sure it only has two. And it does. Fantastic. So now our dynamic modal is working. We can close this for now. This for now. Okay, fantastic. Now, something we can also do for another kind of backup is add these two lines. Can just copy them, and we can also paste them to our close modal function. I find that sometimes that helps because sometimes it might not kick in the method itself, and so we can catch it up here as well, just to kind of give it two different options. Okay, so the last thing I want to work on today is delete the role. Okay, which will be, let's see, it'll be in the table. It'll be this delete button. So in here, we can now do add click equals delete role, and then we need to pass in the role. So what we can do now is come down to our methods and let's see, just copy and paste this one for now. Copy, paste. We'll say we haven't made the route yet, but that's okay. So delete role, this form, delete this route, roles, destroy. We need to also pass in the role here. And now here, we can just say role, and that should be good because we're passing in the whole role object. Okay, so why don't we go back to the browser and see if we can delete one of these, refresh. And let's go ahead and delete this last one that we put in. Oops, close that, delete. And let's just check here. See, we don't have the suite alert yet, so it's not going to do it right away. But let's just double check and see. Looks like we got an error. Siggy, or, oh, we didn't make the route yet. My bad. Okay, so web routes. Okay, now we can just do copy paste. Delete role, and then this, and this will be destroy. And then let's open up the controller again and head down to that method. Now I can close this up and do role delete and then return back. Okay, so now let's try it again and this should definitely work, or almost 99.99% certain it'll work. Okay, so let's go down to one of the bottom ones, delete. Cool, it's gone. Fantastic. Let's delete that one. Cool. Let's refresh and make sure that it is definitely, most definitely gone. Okay, fantastic. I'm going to leave it there for now. In the next episode, we are going to introduce Suite Alert to this table. I'm going to make sure to post all this stuff up to GitHub. I'll leave the link down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.